So, dear colleagues, I would like to introduce preliminary results of the protocol with combined treatment of soft tissue sarcomas with radiation therapy, which was developed in the Petrovs Institute. Today, we've talked a lot that soft tissue sarcomas is quite a rare pathology. It's from 1 to 3% of all malignancies. And along with that, we know that there is some trend to grow in that incidence among adults. WHO classification talks about more than 156 subtypes, which as malignancy degree affects the disease development. If we look at the distribution of histological subtypes by age, we can see that some histological subtypes, like rhabdomyosarcoma, they are most frequently seen in the first, second decade of life, and leiomyosarcomas, they increase incidence with aging. The most frequent place for soft tissue sarcomas are extremities, then trunk, and when we talk about the stage, when diagnosis is established, then more than half of the adult age sarcomas are seen with a local spread without regional or remote metastasis. And frequency of local relapses, according to different authors, vary quite widely and could reach up to 60%. Results of the combined treatment of soft tissue sarcomas showed that combined treatment, surgery plus radiotherapy, significantly increases relapse-free period and decreases risks for local relapse. Radiation therapy could be provided as in pre-op and in post-op mode, but pre-op radiation therapy has several advantages, such as diminishing biological aggressiveness, decrease of implantation potential, which makes surgery more ablastic. Moreover, if we do radiation therapy prior to surgery, we more accurately can define tumor volume and thus better plan radiation volume. But pre-op radiation therapy has a very important disadvantage, meaning a significant increase of risk for severe post-op complications. In 2004, there have been published results of the large randomized trial, which showed that from the point of view of the local control, there is no statistical significant difference between radiation therapy before and or after surgery. However, the authors noticed a bit advantage of the patients from the point of view of overall survival when the radiation therapy was provided before surgery. Then talking about post-op complications, then in the group with pre-op radiation therapy, the post-op complication rate was higher almost two times. That's why post-op radiation therapy at the moment is used, pre-op radiation therapy is used more frequently, but on the other hand, we lose those positive sides of pre-op radiation therapy. Last days, we study hyperfractionation. For instance, Northwest group for studying soft tissue sarcomas, they published a regimen of stereotaxic radiation therapy as hyperfractionation mode, and the data showed there were no increase in post-op complications. Talking about the local control, similar results were seen for both either with normal and with hyperfractionation. Also, we shouldn't forget about systemic effects of radiation therapy before surgery. When during radiation we destroy tumor DNA and through antigen-presenting cells, we manage to reach to such an abscopal effect. And that made us to develop the protocol for combined treatment of soft tissue sarcomas, which was registered in the International Registry for Clinical Studies. It consists of three stages. First stage is pre-op stereotactic radiation therapy in the hyperfractionation mode and with a radiation volume only within tumor tissue. It was set up with radical surgery, and the third stage was post-op radiation of the zone of subclinical tumor spread using standard dose fractionation. In order to implement radiation effect, the second stage of surgery is done in 3-4 weeks after pre-op surgery was finished, and post-op radiation is done in 30 to 60 days which makes possible to reach complete wound healing. So the first stage is a stereotactic radiation therapy. After CT and MRI markup, those images are fused and radiation fields are formed. Two radiation volumes are used, is CTB1 along the tumor margin with a single focus dose is 5 gray up to total focal dose of 25 gray. We use CTV2 as a second radiation volume, which goes in within the tumor 1 centimeter, and a single local dose, focal dose is 7 gray, with total focal dose of 35 grays. With such, here with dose planning, we see rather hot spot within the tumor. Using such two fields, on one hand, helps us to save the structures which we'd like to spare, such as skin, surrounding nervous and so to say, blood vessel structures. On the other hand, it provides optimal anti-tumor effect. Second stage is radical removal of soft tissue tumors with post-op histology and morphology and assessing tumor regression, both with macroscopy and microscopy. We can see the difference in the tumor tissues before and after radiation therapy. We see parts of necrosis and fibrosis with less cell density. And so stage 3D conform distant radiation therapy is neural fractionation, 25 fractions, with a single focal dose of 2 grays up to total dose of 50 grays at the bed of the removed mass. You see that the dose distribution is more, it looks smoother with large volume. So preliminary results. From June 2018 till January 2021, the protocol included 26 patients. Out of them, 14 completed the treatment with follow-up median of 20 months, from 12 to 28 months. Majority of patients were females. And along with that, the most frequent histological subtypes were liposarcoma, which correlates with the data of in international publications. The tumor size was assessed according to TNM, 8th edition. Mostly, tumors were located at the lower extremities. It was primary soft tissue sarcomas. The majority of them were high-grade sarcomas. After stereotactic radiation therapy, two patients developed post-radiation epithelitis, grade 1. No other complications were detected. Talking about the radicality of tumor removal was reached in 100% of cases. In 100% of cases, the wound was covered with local tissues, and also the wound healed in a primary fashion in 5 weeks, and the time for microscopic therapeutic metamorphosis was about 46%. Two patients post-period developed lymphorrhea, which required long drainage. That's why start of post-op radiation therapy was delayed by 79 days. And resection of those patients was in those patients was done because of sarcomas with size of about exceeding 15 centimeters. After post-op radiation therapy, four patients showed radiation epithelitis, grade 1, in two cases lymphostasis, grade 2, which never required any surgical treatment. However, but during the observation, there were two cases of severe post-op complications with necrosis of one case was skin flap necrosis and resulted in intervention, and in one case a patient developed joint stiffness which required all in 5 months, which required also additional surgery. So talking about the long-term follow-up, patients didn't develop any local relapse. Four patients developed generalizations of process, three cases of metastatic lung metastasis, in one case of patient developed bone metastasis. I should say, in the end, this protocol is quite interesting with its biological effects and also assessment of patients' immunological status and response to stereotactic radiation therapy. And I would like to thank all the participants, all the members of our multidisciplinary team for a very good and, so to say, nice work and cooperation.